Hey guys, in this video I'm going to do something slightly different where I'm going to pit up two Samsung's flagship telly. On your left hand side you have the Samsung's KS9000 2016 HDR flagship telly, and on the right side you have 8 series flagship, the HU8500. Now both of these tellies are 4K. The difference is the HDR premium features, and again latest model compared to the new, so the new generation versus the old generation. We're going to pit these two up against each other. First thing that I want you guys to notice is the depth of color. On the KS9000 you have so much vibrant colors, where the opposite with the HU8500, it is colorful but not as vibrant as you would have on the HDR set. Again, I need you guys to bear in mind these are not HDR content, neither are they 4K content as well. All of this is true resolution 1080p. I've recorded this video in 4K so that way it can, you know, show some clear resolution. Now both of these are going to be set on gaming mode, exactly the same setting. I've already got the game mode set up on the KS9000, and on the 8500 I'm going to also demonstrate to you that I have the game mode as well. They're both switch on, so both of these are on the exact same game mode and the exact same settings as well. Just to demonstrate to you guys, all of these games are going to be played on the exact same settings. So you've got the backlight there, 20 on one end, 20 on the other end. You've got the brightness 35, and then the brightness on the other one 45. Now I've put that for a specific reason which I'll show you guys. Contrast both are showing 100, sharpness are both at 30, color and tint are exactly the same, both 50-50. And if we go further down, in order to go into the advanced settings, you're gonna have to go into advanced. On the other one, it's all in one page. So you've got dynamic contrast, I've put to high. And if we go further down as well, both high. Black tone, now we don't really have black tone because the HDR telly has so much dark blacks in it. It's like an LCD, the darkest that you could possibly find output. The RGB is off, color native, I've put for both of those. White balance, you could only get 2 points, but I've left them exactly balanced and normal. So everything is exactly the same. If we go back and we go further into the other settings, gamma is 3, and on top it's exactly the same as well, 3. I need to go back out and into the picture options to look at more options. Color tone is set at standard on the other end. The HDMI black level, low for both, and the UHD color, because I've got 4K contents, I tend to put that with everything that I've got connected. So those are exactly the same, and I think that's pretty much all of it. Now the reason why I decided to put the brightness difference is because on the HDR set it's just too bright. I'm going to put the one onto the right to 70. Now watch what happens when I put it up to the same level. The HDR set is just too bright. It wouldn't really be fair. So the only way that I could make them to match up together is to go down by 10 in regards to the brightness. Because if I was, again, if you look on the right hand side, it's just too dark and it's still too bright on the other side. So I decided to put 35 just to make it come close to match up to the one on the right hand side. So that's enough for me. I'm going to show you guys some gameplay on the PlayStation 4. Hope you enjoy, and let's get down to it.
On the active praetor suit, it appears that I can accelerate the upgrading of your arsenal by measuring your combat effectiveness. I have added a tracker to your helmet's display.
The facility will not allow you access to the turbine room unless the demonic threat level is brought down inside the foundry. Our security systems cannot be overridden.
frequency accident patterns.
temporarily disabling the tower. You need to remove each lens individually. Carefully release the hinge.
Warning. Energy contamination detected.
Destroying the production of Martian energy isn't necessary.
daylight saying, Victor?
Right now, not a goddamn thing. Lost the signal.
Hey, you know what never loses signal? Paper. All right, this route right here should take us straight to the volcano. Might get a little bumpy, though. Let's get the show on the road.
So, what are we looking for out here?
Well, the map shows all these structures around the volcano. Some abandoned outposts, a handful of watchtowers.
Watchtowers?
Avery was the most wanted man in the world. So if he was hiding something out here, it makes sense he'd need lookouts. One of those towers is right on the volcano.
With Avery's trench.
Fingers crossed.
I see some ruins up ahead.
Wait here, I'll go take a look. Oh, Victor, you still do a lot of traveling these days?
Yeah, I try. I tend to rig jobs that get me away from the computer.
Yeah, I was telling Nate that it's shocking how much business is. I bet you have all sorts of options to get rid of hot cargo now.
Yeah, sure. I prefer talking to clients face to face. Get a good read on them. Hard to do that in a chat room. I'm talking to some guy named Antiquity Master 37.
Nice to see you. Well, nothing worthwhile. Come on, let's keep going. Hey, so with our luck, what are the odds this volcano is going to erupt on us?
Zero. It's extinct. That's the first thing I learned. That when we said we were heading for a volcano. We're direct the cheapest format.
Wait, Sully, you're telling me that you actually did some research?
Can't let you be the know-it-all every time.
That bridge there is what you would call rickety. This looks promising. Come on, baby. Let's go, 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 go!
Thank you.
You see any more? Are we clear?
I think we're clear.
You all right?
Yeah. Just a little winded.
No. Quite the crow's nest, huh? There it is. Just on the other side of the river. Now, how do you say we go? Rob from the rich, huh? Hey, is there a path down there?
Of sorts. Come on. How long do you think it'll take us to get the new net?
A couple hours. Depends on what or who we bump into along the way.
Come on, up here! I'm on the wall!
sense.
Taking the Rikers out at the knees. There's no one who can replace Lorraine Baron. She's the one who organized the escape to Manhattan.
They're holding three of my people there. If you can get them out before blowing the lid off, I'd be grateful.
All right.
don't want any trouble.
Patience is the first thing you learn to have. Second, it's a lot cheer.
Adam, you're here. You made it in. It's good to see you're okay.
Hey, Aria, yeah. It was a close call. I got lucky. A lot of people didn't.
I was here working when the first reports came in. It was chaos. Phones ringing off the hook, people yelling, scrambling to find out what was going on. Then when Miller told me you were there,
I'm all right.
Good. You looking for him? Because he's tied up right now, meeting with Leon, I think.
Really? He's using the NSA right now?
Yeah, I just saw him. Oh, hey, that reminds me, here's yours.
What's this?
The card for the shooting range. Chang changed all the codes this morning, said something about only giving access to people he's vetted personally. The bombing really freaked him out. Third one in 6 months, can you believe it? I'm really glad you're okay.
Thanks, Aria. I'll let you get back to what you were doing.
Yeah, I better get back downstairs. It's gonna be a busy day. Come by later if you want to talk.
I'll be there.
Came in. It was chaos. Phones ringing off the hook, people yelling, scrambling to find out what was going on. Then when Miller told me...
Nothing suspicious here.
Check the perimeter, man.
What was that?
just gotta keep looking.
Yet another augmented terror attack. 250 passengers aboard Sista Airlines Flight 4. An augmented passenger broke into the plane's cockpit and ruthlessly butchered its flight crew. Details from the black box recorder suggest that the man may have been suffering flashbacks to the